time. But if you really don't love me, no, I know, no, somebody that will. Hear me. You disrespect me right in my face. Disrespect me right in my face. I saw someone else I don't know. I need to take the blame. But if you really don't love me, I know, no. That's somebody right here in Boca Raton, Florida. We So, I would like to just have a quick conversation with you, if you don't mind, because it's a beautiful day. And simply for the fact that, to my knowledge, and after I get you saying what I'm saying, you'll understand why I said, to the best of my knowledge, this is my first time coming to Boca Raton, Florida. So a brief little backstory, because this is how I gauge the energy of the crowd that I'm playing in front of. So, you know, my story goes back just a little bit, and I appreciate you guys for bearing with me in this heat. As you see, y'all not the only one. I'm up here burning up with you. So, but I'm gonna play my ass off regardless, if that's okay with you. So, a little bit of my backstory, I get very, very emotionally involved in every single note that I play. There's a reason for that. It's because for about 20 plus years of my life, I lived it going the wrong direction. The wrong direction meaning that I was engulfed in nothing but pure, unadulterated addiction in every way that you could think about. So, I don't mind being an open book and explaining to you, because there may be some people that have no clue about what I stand for or what I'm doing up here, or it's just not about the guitar. My life is what I'm playing from. So, with that being said, I almost killed myself about 5 or 6 different times. See, that quietness is exactly what I know that lets me know that you're listening to what I'm saying, because this is so serious about my life. I almost died about 5 or 6 different times because I was so out of my mind. I was completely out of my mind. Miserableness was comfortable for me. So I explain this for a reason, because you're going to see all kind of erratic movement and behavior from me while I'm playing during this 90 minutes. It's because I can't help it. With that being said, I want y'all to know that I am a survivor. I survived all that bullshit that I've been through in life. And also, this is how I gauge what kind of energy that you guys are giving me. This is what I want to find out, how loud you can get. Wait. The good part is, as I stand in front of you in this beautiful city with this beautiful setting, I stand in front of you with almost 2.5 years clean and sober. Woo! Kind of energy you gonna give me, because I promise you I'm gonna give it to you 1 billion times even more. So I am very, very grateful to be part of a massive, great festival. Both of these artists after me are friends of mine from way back, long time ago. Me and Warren Hain go way back, like 2001, 2002, long time ago. And me and Evan Bishop goes back quite a ways too. So this is awesome to be part of this festival in a beautiful place. So with that being said, I got a piece of music that I want to play, and it's by an iconic man by the name of Freddie King. And the name of it is called Boogeyman, and I hope y'all enjoy it. Mm-hmm. down to do the boogie boogie, y'all. Now I can't go back at all. They call me the. We'll be right back.
Is everybody doing okay out there?
Right now.
Turn it up.
Says he's about to park.
Turn it up.
I just asked him, is it far?
Why didn't he text me?
Turn it up.
Well, that's because I don't know. I text him.
Have you heard what this
said,
guy
where
said?
You at, man?
All I heard was the last half of what he said. He said, now that was some good shit right there, brother. I promise you it's coming, but it's late in the show. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming, brother. I promise you. So, man. So I see that you may notice that I keep making sure that I stay hydrated while I play, because it's very important, and I highly encourage you guys and girls to stay hydrated too, because the heat is no joke. So when you can put your hands on some water or whatever you're drinking out there, stay hydrated, whatever it may be. I don't want nobody to need the paramedics or nothing like that. So y'all stay with me. I need you to stay with me at least for 75 more minutes at least. So this is awesome, man. This is better than a workout at the gym, I tell you. We're gonna keep going. I got more for you. Thank you. Myself, I tell you. I got more, is that okay?
Thank you.
It's been so long since I could say that I'm always another day. I said I'm done standing in my way. Oh Lord, let the light shine despite me. It's been so long. Reject myself From now on, I'll be kind to me. It's been so long, long. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, oh yeah, as hot as it is up here, the show is going to continue to happen. If you see and notice, everybody has a fan but me. Well, it's kind of hard to follow me because I'm all over the place. But right now, I would like to introduce all of you to my bass player and my drummer. Y'all give it up for Byron Carter on the bass. And on the drums, y'all give it up for Nicholas Hayes. Check this out, you're gonna like it, check it out. Thank you.
but that part right there that I just got through playing, I always envisioned myself playing to a massive stadium of people. That's what I see. So I know I'm up here giving it everything I can, I at least for at least 2 minutes. Can it look like I'm looking at a stadium of people? 1, 2! You guys are awesome, man. That felt wonderful, man. So I got more. I got something I'd like to play for you, and a matter of fact, we're around some water right now. And what I'm about to play is track number 11. So at the count of three, if all of y'all could scream back at me, track number 11, I'm doing it for a purpose. 1, 2, 3. Let's try it again. 1, 2, 3.
Track number 11.
The name of this song is called Swamp, by the way. And there is a reason for it. I am in it.
Galactic.
I am in it. All of us boys, Byron, Nick, and myself, we've had our turn. We've been in the playground, and we've all had solos and played around in the sandbox and the swings and everything. We had our turn. But now, Boca Raton, I'd really like for you to understand that now it's time for some real woman power to happen up here right now. It's about to get really serious up here. So the history behind this song, that it has taken me at least 10 to 15 minutes to calm the crowd down after I play this song. But let's see what Boca Raton feels about it. And ladies and gentlemen, this young lady back here is giving it everything she got. I gotta tell you that the sun is blinding the shit out of her, but she's doing everything she can to try to follow my instructions as we're up here playing our butts off. And she's a little bit more than just a band member. So I would really appreciate it if y'all put y'all hands together real loudly for my lovely wife, Miss Lavanna Gale! D- This is going to feature her, so keep your eye on the things she's about to do. It's going to be quite amazing. So I hope that you enjoy yourself. This is track number 11, and it's about to start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you. I tried to explain to you what was about to happen, but A, it's not over because there's another level to what just happened. And I wanna make sure everybody in within the listening radius gets a chance to feel that power that's going on in this park right now. So, with that being said, the kind of guy that I am, I'm gonna give y'all one more try. And if you feel like getting off your feet, that's all right with me too. 1, 2, 3! Now that was track number 11, by the way. So, I have a little bit of bad news. Well, I played in this town called Sanford last night. Nonetheless, it was packed. It was an amazing show. We had a wonderful time. It was amazing. But, police, Oh, well, I don't know nothing about that. I mean, my days of that is over. So I can kindly shake their hand and not be worried nowadays, so I'm okay. But the merchandise that I brought for you guys, Sanford bought me out. So all I have, all I have is, this CD has track number 11, it has Boogeyman, it has Been So Long, damn near everything that I play, but all I have over there is 11 CDs left. And I hope that I could get rid of them with the number of people here. And even if you don't buy something, I'm gonna be right over there after the show. Let's take photos and load them up on Bookface or Twitter or Twatter or whatever you guys subscribe to. You like that, Bookface and Twatter, huh? But to try to make up for it, I heard a guy ask me at the beginning of the show, man, I want to hear some Hendrix, yeah? So I didn't answer him because normally I say, you know what, I'm going to honor your request, but I got a whole lot of Eric Gales I want to get out of the way first. So now the time has come that I'm about to give you some Jimi Hendrix. Is that all right with you? Woo!
I'll give it right back to you. Thank you.
You know something that I'm very, 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 very proud of? And this is something that I know that the production and all of the people behind the scenes and bands that come on after bands that play at festivals, this is a fucking cause for a celebration because I stopped exactly on my time that I'm supposed to. So, you know what? I can guarantee you that the excitement is going to continue throughout the night because the guy that's responsible for making this festival happen put a pretty badass lineup together, man. So, I'm not going to say who and I'm not going to say when, but there has been some discussions going on in the back as to a possible jam, and I'm not gonna say nothing, but I'm gonna leave it alone. With that being said, all I wanna let you know is I tried to play my heart out, I tried to give y'all everything I had, and I truly hope y'all enjoyed yourselves, man, I really do. And let me say this before I leave. Boca Raton, I am going to send an email to my booking agent and make sure that it's not so long before I come back and visit you again. Y'all give it up for Byron Carter on the bass and keys. Y'all give it up for Ballhead Nick Hayes on the drums. Y'all gotta get loud for my lovely wife, LaDonna Gale! Hardest working man in show business, my tech, Gavin McKee! Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Eric Gales. Thank y'all so much. I'll see you at the merch table. Thank you!